To begin creating your own drag and drop exercise, you have to first locate it from the H5P activities list. Look it up in the list. When you find it, click on it in order to choose it. First, provide a title for your activity. Type it in title field. Now, let's add a background picture to our exercise. This picture will be used as the area where our items should be dropped. When the upload is complete, we can begin inserting the draggable items on our drop zones. To do so, we have to click on the next step, step 2, which is named Task. Always begin by setting your drop zones. Let's add all the drop zones of our picture. To do so, click on the Add Drop Zone button located on the left corner of the task window. Keep in mind that the following process has to be repeated for every single drop zone you add. First, type a title at the label field for this particular drop zone. Make sure to type a distinctive title so you won't confuse this label with the following ones. When you are done, set the zone's opacity to 50%. We do that because otherwise we won't be able to view the zone's contents. Click Done. Your first drop zone is now ready. Move the drop zone at its exact location. This is crucial since the drop zone dictates where the item can be placed correctly. Now it's time to add more drop zones. To speed up the process, we will copy our first drop zone and then paste it by pressing the appropriate buttons. After we move the second drop zone to the correct area, we have to edit it so we can change its name. To do so, click on the Edit button. Then, type the new title and click Done. Let's repeat the process for all the 6 remaining drop zones. Now that our drop zones are set, it's time to place our droppable elements on the corresponding drop zones. To do so, click on the Text button located at the left side of the task window. First, give a title to your element. This is meaningful since its title will be displayed for the learner to see. Next, enable all the available drop zones at the Select Drop Zones list. We do that because we want the learner to be able to drop the element in all droppable zones. Then set the item's opacity and click Done when you have finished. Adjust the element's location to suit your needs. Place it in a noticeable location. If it's necessary, alter the item's opacity as shown in the example by clicking the Edit button over the element you would like to edit. Repeat the process for all the droppable elements of your quiz. Do not forget that in order to speed up the process, you can copy the first element and paste it as a new one. If you do that, please do not forget that you should always change its name. Now it's time to link the droppable element or elements with the correct drop zone. To do so, please click on the first drop zone and click the Edit button. You can now see all the created elements at the Select Correct Elements list. Click on the element or elements that the learner has to place on the first drop zone. When you have finished, click the Done button. Repeat the process until all of your elements are assigned to a drop zone. Now that everything is set, we have to provide feedback to the learner according to the exercise's score. To do that, we need to change a few things at the overall feedback section of the activity. Let's suppose that we need our learners to score at least 80% in order to finish this activity successfully. This means that if they score 0% to 79%, they need to do the exercise again. Click on Add Range to add the custom feedback of your choice. In this example, if the score received is from 0 to 79%, the system will notify the learner to try again. On the other hand, if the learner receives more than 80%, the system will give another custom feedback. Notice that you can add as many custom feedbacks as you like, as long as their ranges do not overlap one another. Before we finish the creation of the activity, we need to set the necessary completion criteria. First, let's set the passing grade for this exercise. In our example, since we want our learners to receive 80% to finish this activity, we shall set our score to 8 out of 10. Finally, we need to make Moodle consider this exercise as complete when the user receives a grade. Click on Activity Completion area and change the Completion Tracking field to show activity as complete when conditions are met. Then, enable the Require Grade option, which forces Moodle to consider this exercise as complete when the user receives a score. This option, combined with the grade criteria that we have just set, will instruct Moodle that the user will not receive a completion mark unless the score is equal or higher with the passing grade. When you are done, click on Save and Display button to see how your activity looks like.